lesson planning, how to formulate effective learning objectives. Like we said, one of the first things you should do when making a format lesson plan is to define some clear and effective learning objectives. What is a learning objective, and how is it different from a standard? Standards come from the curriculum. They are a set of goals that determine the content of a course across the whole country to guarantee that all students receive the same standard of education. A seventh grader in a rural school will be expected to have the same knowledge and usage of language as the students in the capital. A learning objective, though, is way more specific. It's how a teacher knows what outcomes their students have to achieve by the end of the unit. Learning objectives are student-centered and describe what the students can do by the end of the unit or lesson. They must be measurable, able to be assessed, observable, able to be seen or heard or read, and focused on a specific skill. It's the learning objectives that allow you to create and run an effective lesson. The objectives are essentially this: tools for planning to ultimately meet the national curriculum goals, tools for the teachers to evaluate the lesson and students' progress, a system that lets you plan a lesson in the right order while selecting the right instructional methods. Well-written learning objectives have these four parts: learner, performance, standard, and condition. Learner, performer. Learners are students. Objectives should always be student-centered and focused on what the students will be able to accomplish. Performance. This is the skill or action that students will be expected to do during the lesson. It's best to use action verbs like activate, analyze, demonstrate, describe, or produce in this part. Standard. This states how well students have to perform to be considered competent. Standards should be specific and related to the lesson. Standards might answer questions like how often, how well, how many, and how much. Here are some examples of standards: answering 7 out of 10 questions correctly, making no more than one mistake, identifying 10 leisure activities, conjugating 6 irregular verbs, writing 5 sentences about their family, describing a picture using 10 different adjectives. Condition. This should describe any possible conditions for the performance. This combines any input from the teachers, like the text to be read, the exercises, simulations with the time students are expected to achieve the standard. Here are some examples of common conditions: by the end of the lesson, after reading the text My Family, after this unit, during the simulation activity. Follow this 3-step process to create learning objectives. Choose a standard. What do you want the outcome or product of the lesson to be? Create a condition such as, after completing the lesson, the students will be able to. Choose an action verb to describe the performance. What will the students have to do to succeed? Check out this example. By the end of the lesson, students will be able to describe their dream vacation to the rest of the class, using at least 4 of the key vocabulary words and at least 1 visual aid. Remember that all the time you spend writing measurable, detailed, and clear learning objectives makes the unit or the lesson planning process a lot easier. Learning objectives define and guide your activities, your assessments, and which teaching materials you should use.